Hello everyone and welcome back. So in this video, we are going to learn that how you can set up your Flutter project with Firebase. So let's get started. First, create a new Flutter project. As you can see over here, I have created one named Flutter Firebase To-Do app. Now after this, open your Google Chrome and then type Firebase. Here you will get the very first link firebase.google.com. After clicking on this link, you have to create your Firebase account. Okay, now as you can see over here that after creating my account, I have landed on this screen. Okay, so first we will create a new project. So click on this button, create a project. Now after this, it will ask you to give a name for your project. So here as you can see, I have given the name to this project Flutter Fire To-Do app. Okay, you can give any name that you want to do. Okay, so because we are going to create a Firebase To-Do app, that's why I've given this name. Now after this, click over here, I accept the Firebase terms and then continue. Now over here, by default, the Firebase project will enable the Google Analytics for this project. So it is up to you whether you want it to be enabled or disabled. Okay, so I'm keeping it as it is. Okay. Then we'll click on continue. Now after this, you have to select your location. Okay. And again, just click on this, I accept the Google Analytics tab. So now this will be creating our Firebase project. Okay. Now click on continue. So here, as you can see, this is our Flutterfire To-Do app project screen. Okay. So now we want to connect about this Firebase project with our Flutter project. Okay. So to get started with this, we'll click on this Android icon. Okay. Now we want to register our app. So here we have to give our application name. Okay. Our package name. So go to your Flutter project. Okay. Over here inside the Android folder, click on this app folder and get inside the source folder. Over here you will find a folder named main, and over here we will get to our AndroidManifest.xml file. Over here, it has mentioned our package name. So just copy this name, okay, and just paste it over here. Okay. Now, if you want to provide any nickname for this app, so we'll be providing Flutter Fire To-Do app. Okay. Now below this, we are having a field for SHA-1 key. Okay. Now SHA-1 key is a secure key. Okay. Or you can say unique key generated for your PC that can be used for signing in. Okay. Which is mainly used for submitting for using the Google APIs. Okay. And it is also used to store very important data. So to generate a SHA key, go to your project. Okay. Now over here, go to your Android folder. And over here you can see this Gradle W file. Okay. Now now right click on this file. Okay. And click on the option open in terminal. Now to see the SHA key of your application, you just have to type Gradle W and you have to write signing report. Okay. This should be the exact syntax. Okay. The letter R should be capital of report. Okay. And then just press enter. It will take some time, but it will give you the list of the SHA keys for your application. And there are types of SHA keys, whether they are for debugging SHA key and if you want to release your app in release mode. Okay. So there is also a SHA key for release mode as well. Okay. So we will be using debug mode key and release mode key as well. Okay. So as you can see, it is showing starting daemon, and after some time it will give you the list of your keys. Now we will be needing this key because in our To-Do app we are going to provide one authentication screen as well, and in this authentication the user will be authenticated via signing in with their Google accounts, okay, via their Gmails. So that's why we will be needing this SHA keys. Okay. So as you can see over here, it has generated a list of our SHA-1 keys. Okay. So we will be needing a debug key and our release key. Okay. So the variant name having debug, okay, that will be our debug SHA-1 key, okay. So you can just copy paste this and print it over here, okay. And after this, just click on register your app. So right now, you can just write only one key, but we can add our release mode key as well. I will show you how to do it. But first, we have to click on this register app. Okay. So after the registration of our app is successful, now here we have to download this googleservice.json file. Okay. So click on this download button. So we have to place this file inside the app folder of our Android project. Okay. So this is our file. I have copied it. And now I will place it inside this app folder. Okay. So this is your, so now we have also successfully placed our googleservices.json file as well. Now after placing this JSON file, click on the next button. Now here we have to add this Firebase SDK. Now you have to follow the instructions as they are shown over here. Okay, just go step by step. So first, what we have to do, we have to go to the project level build Gradle file. Okay. And we have to add this line in the dependencies section. So just copy it from over here. Okay. Then we'll go to our project build Gradle file. Okay. And we will paste it over here. Okay. After this, we have to check whether the following line, okay, whether it is in our repository section or not. So let us check. So it is already there. Now we will go to our app level build file, okay, and we will add this line as well. And paste it over here. Now we will import the dependencies for Firebase. Okay, so again copy this line and paste it inside the dependencies section, which is over here. And copy this line as well. So now as you can see, we have added all the dependencies and we have completed all the steps. Okay. Now just click on the next button. And now we have completed all the steps as you can see. So we'll click on this continue to the console. Okay. So now here we are gonna close all the files. Okay. And here if you want to sync your files with your devices, so you can. So now we have completed all the steps. So now we'll simply check whether our Firebase project have been set up with our Flutter project. Okay, so click on the terminal and here just type Flutter run, or you can simply run it from over here. So if our applications get successfully built on our device, that means that we have successfully established our setup with Firebase. Okay. So as you can see over here, after running the Flutter run command, our app has been successfully installed and this is how it is gonna look like on our device. Okay. So this is the default code of a counter app, but our app has been successfully installed. Okay. And it is running. So that means that our setup with Firebase project have been successfully established. Okay. So in our next video, we will see how to sign in with Google in our Flutter projects. Okay. So till then, keep practicing and keep fluttering.